Welcome to this module, and we are going to discuss the structure of wheat grain. In this module, I'm going to just give you the outline, how the structure it look like and what are the main parts of the wheat grain. Wheat grain, it actually consists of three major parts. And if you are going to see the grains from their outer layers, you are going to see, have you ever seen a wheat grain? You all might have seen the wheat grain. And what is unique about this grain? Yes, this wheat grain is very unique because it is having a central crease in its in the center. In its structure, it is having a central crease, which makes it unique. You can visualize any other grain, you are not going to see the central crease in any other grain, whether it is rice, maize, bajra, whatever grain you can take, there is no central crease except wheat grain. So this central crease actually makes the milling complex. Now we'll be discussing about the layers, but before that, what you know about wheat? One thing I told you about the structure, that there is a central crease, and if I dive into the history, yes, they confirm that wheat, whether it is Triticum aestivum, Triticum durum, Triticum compactum, there were the earliest field crops which were being used for humans in food processing and as human food. And the cultivation of wheat, it reaches back, if I go back into the history, it was a predominant source of food for humans. And the precise origin of wheat cultivation is unclear, but it is thought that the man has been cultivating and processing the wheat for at least 12,000 to 17,000 years. The seed portion of the cereal, it consists of numerous components, but basically there are three parts. One is seed coat, the outer bran layer, it is having seed coat or testa. Then the endosperm, the mealy part, which we use to consume. This is the storage organ or the nutritive reserve for the seed. Then there is a miniature plant or the germ part, which actually gives birth to the plant, which actually germinates, helps in germination of the plant. The fruit tissue, it consists of a layer of epidermis and several thin layers. And these thin layers have some few cells which are thick. This is how you can see the wheat grain. There is a central crease center in the center. Depression is there. Then the pericarp. This is the outer covering. Then the seed coat is there. Endosperm is there. And the germ part is lying below. So wheat grain structure, the brain layer, it is rich in fiber, iron and vitamin B. The endosperm part is having good amount of starch and proteins, mainly gluten. And the germ, it's very rich in fat, vitamin B, iron and proteins. This is the wheat grain structure we are going to discuss in our next modules. We will be discussing about all the layers in the bran. We'll be discussing what type of cells are present in the endosperm, and then the three parts of the germ. It's plumule, which gives rise to the shoot part, then the radicle, which gives rise to the root part, and scutellum, which separates it from the endosperm and provides the and mobilizes all the nutrient components which are being present in the endosperm to the germ during growth. So thank you, students, and you have to do an assignment. You have to draw the structure of wheat grain, and we are going to meet you in the next session. Till then, have happy learning. Thank you.